YouTube. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to get the Galastropods or snails in Astroneer. So the first step is you need to get a furnace. The way you unlock the quest line to get all of these, to get the Galastropod quest, is by getting a furnace. So you have to complete the smeltering hot quest, which is basically you mine. You unlock a furnace by you hit tab. You go over here to medium printer, and then you unlock this. Pretty sure it's 250 bytes to unlock it. Then you print it in a large in a medium printer, and then you mine 3 laterite, and then you complete that quest, and then you should get bait and switch. Then you have to collect 1 sphalerite. I don't know how to pronounce this. You have to get 1 of these after you get the quest from mining, importing it from a soil centrifuge or a trade platform will not work. And after you do it, you will get this weird item. Strange object. But basically, this will summon, whenever you use it, it summons a lab, where you study and get quests for the Galastropods. Now, I do want to warn you though, this is, after you put it down, well, there are 3 things actually. One, it has, when you put it down, it has to be on Sylva. It has to be on the starting planet or else it will not let you place it down. It has to be above ground, it can't be under any ground. It'll tell you all the errors, but the main thing I wanted to say, you only get 1 of these. And after you place it down, you can't move it, it's there forever. So, just be smart about where you're putting it. Because, you know, you don't want to end up with it blocking something, or being in an annoying spot. You cannot activate due to blocking objects. It's slightly touching that platform right there. There you go. Whenever you can place it, you can anchor it like that, and then it'll turn all weird like this. And you can use it. And there we go. It has now been summoned. So, yep, we just completed the strange object quest. Get 1 power cells. The next quest you get is, or you get 2 actually, a breath of fresh air, install an oxygenator in the xenobiology lab, and you also get jumper cables. It needs its internal power to find a working cable on part of its structure. So this part is really easy. I'm just gonna bring this over here, plug it in. So you hardly need any energy. And then you don't even, it requires 1 bar of, it requires like 8 units of power or something, incredibly small. It will, whenever it spawns, it will spawn debris, sometimes in particularly annoying spots, such as right here, specifically, there's debris in my platform right here. I cannot get rid of it without digging, which is really annoying considering I don't even have a shredder yet because I just started and my goal was not to get a shredder. But yeah, having a shredder is useful. It summons a ton of this stuff and it's annoying. Anyway, after you've charged it up, now we just need to put an oxygenator in it. We can make 1 for 1 aluminum and 1 ceramic. So I'm just gonna go and get everything I need because for some reason I don't have ceramic yet. Also, you're gonna wanna have a tether system over to a forest biome because we're gonna need to go there for like 1 of the next quests. Alright guys, so I finally found clay, but I used literally like 2 inventory fulls. Like 2 inventories full of tethers to actually get to it. And it is gonna take like 3 years to get back. So I'll be back in a minute. So the reason I wanted to find clay is because now that I have clay, I can make ceramic, which one, I needed for the main, the Galastropods thing, that, like, the main thing I'm doing for this, but also, that's the last thing I need to request that'll unlock me the soil centrifuge, so I'll actually be able to make clay without walking all of this. It's literally been, like, 3 minutes, since I was, last recording. And that's probably not a lot for endgame players, but for me, I don't like it. Alright, I finally have my oxygenator. Put that there. Unpack it. There we go. The next quest we get is No Thigh Galastropod. Basically, we use the data log to activate the xenobiology lab's tracker. I already read all this, so you can read this all on yours if you want. I'm not gonna reread it again. Yeah, that's that quest. We got oxygen filters. Now we get the shells. This is the quest that we needed to get to be in the forest for. So we have one. Four, and five. And then from now on, you can just scan them for a bit of research, kind of just like you could scan all the stuff that grows up bushes. I don't remember what they're called. But you can also research them in whatever that's called, a research chamber. But after you do that, you will get an empty terrarium. Now you have to be very specific with this. If you lose it, you don't get another one. You have to keep it or else it's gone. Now, we need to fill it with some stuff. Specifically, soil, like a full can of soil, one bounce fine seed, not a mutant one, specifically just a normal one, with ground mountains, and then zinc. So, it's pretty easy. So I will go off screen and do that right now. Also, it might be a good idea to stock up on seeds, because, to activate the snail's powers, you need seeds. Each snail has a different power, and they get more advanced, as you go on. One of them, from Calidor, I think that's how you pronounce it, basically whenever it's fed and it's in your backpack, you just have oxygen until it's not fed anymore. And one of them, I forget where you get it from, it's the purple planet, I don't remember what it's called. Yeah, it's the purple planet, and I don't remember what that purple planet is called, but basically whenever you have that one in your backpack and it's well fed, you just don't take damage, except for suffocation damage, so when you use those two together, you're just immortal. It's pretty nice. Alright, so now I'm gonna walk up to the terrarium. Now when I put the soil in, which is the last thing I need, it fills up and it's like a little Sylva exhibit. Now we get a small trumpet horn, and we also get the schematic for a small trumpet horn in case we lose it, because it's very important that we have a small trumpet horn. So basically, it makes noise. You can put it on here. And then, Galastropod spawn, or snail. So, basically, perform proper emotes for Gita Sylva. Use Terrarium to collect Gita Sylva. We're gonna take this off. Oh, wait, never mind. Let's not take that off. Yeah. Basically, you walk up to it, you hold G, and you hit a dance. I only have all the default ones, because I don't spend money on my games, really, so. Yeah. Now, we've done that. It is tamed. Oop, nope. Didn't mean to do that, but that's fine. After it's tamed, you can take it off. Then you put the terrarium near it. Then you hold F. It is now in there. So, now, we come over here. That, now we have to verify it. Which we do by taking it and putting it in here. It'll do some stuff. Suddenly, the Galastropod's in there all of a sudden. I don't really know how that happened. And then look, it's back in here. Literal seconds. I'm pretty sure it just teleported. But, anyway. Yeah, there we go. We've got tracking power. Provide more power to the xenobiology lab on. Excuse me. On, Sylva. Use data log to activate xenobiology lab's tracker. So this is all. For the next video, this one will be for next video. So you know what? No. No, let's just do it really fast. It'll take 13. It'll take like 2 seconds. There we go. That's gonna refill. And then let's do this. You can read through that. Get oxygen filters. And then, yeah, it gives you a new quest for the solo, where you go and do the same thing, but that's for next video. I don't even have a rocket yet. So, basically, now I'm just going to show you what this does. Basically, what this one does, is it lights up dark areas whenever it is well fed. The way you feed it is you take a seed, put it on the thing, and then it eats the seed, and now you can see, it just... You can rewind the video, but my everything just lit up. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Goodbye, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. My next video on this will probably be in a couple days, because I gotta do a lot of progressing. But yeah, bye.